Mycorrhizal fungi play key roles in the nutrition of plants. This is critical when it comes to tightly bound soil nutrients such as phosphorus. As non-mycorrhizal roots grow into the soil, most of the phosphorus is unavailable. Compare this to mycorrhizal colonized roots. Here, tiny mycorrhizal filaments called hyphae explore significantly greater volumes of soil resource and excrete powerful enzymes, then unlock phosphorus from soil surfaces and act as a conduit directly back to the plant. The result is improved phosphorus uptake and nutrition.
We have now discovered that there is a multi-directional transfer of nutrients between plants mitigated by the mycelium. So the mycelium is the mother that is giving nutrients from alder and birch trees to hemlock cedars and Douglas firs. In a single cubic inch of soil, there can be more than 8 miles of these cells. My foot is covering approximately 300 miles of mycelium. This is photomicrographs from Nick Reed and Patrick Hickey. And notice that as the mycelium grows, it conquers territory, and then it begins the net. I've been a scanning electron microscopist for many years. I have thousands of electron micrographs. And when I was staring at the mycelium, I realized that there are microfiltration membranes. We exhale carbon dioxide, so does mycelium. It inhales oxygen, just like we do. But these are essentially externalized stomachs and lungs. And I present to you the concept that these are extended neurological membranes. And in these cavities, these microcavities form, and as they fuse soils, they absorb water. These are little wells. And inside these wells, the microbial communities begin to form. And so the spongy soil not only resists erosion, but sets up a microbial universe that gives rise to a plurality of other organisms. I first proposed in the early 1990s that mycelium is Earth's natural internet. When you look at the mycelium, they're highly branched. And if there's one branch that is broken, then very quickly, because of the nodes of crossing, internet engineers maybe call them hop points, there's alternative pathways for channeling nutrients and information. The mycelium is sentient. It knows that you are there. When you walk across landscapes, it leaps up in the aftermath of your footsteps trying to grab debris. So I believe the invention of the computer internet is an inevitable consequence of a previously proven biologically successful model. The Earth invented the computer internet for its own benefit, and we now, being the top organism on this planet, is trying to allocate resources in order to protect the biosphere. Going way out, dark matter conforms to the same mycelial archetype. I believe matter begets life. Life becomes single cells become strings, strings become chains, chains network. And this is the paradigm that we see throughout the universe.